Hi everyone, it's Svenke, and here I am back with part two of my eco dye process. It's a couple of days later, and I am very sorry. I lost my entire video where I shared the revealing of the papers when they were wet. I have downloaded an app on my phone because I use my iPhone when I film my videos, and you can't pause in the video, and I found that very helpful to be able to pause when I did this tutorial. And sorry, it's early, I haven't been talking yet, so my voice is rusty. I took the papers out of the oven, showed you how it looked like in that pan, and paused and did a different setup with my sink, and did the entire reveal while they are wet, and it didn't record. I'm so sorry, but I have shared how I do that in other tutorials of eco dyeing, and you will find several videos in my eco dye playlist, which I will link below. And in the end, it's the dry finished papers that are interesting, right? Because we need to use them all dried up. So here they are. I have been able to place them exactly the way from bottom to top that I put them in the pan. So if you are curious about which kind of leaves and flowers I've used to get these prints, then you can go back to part one and look it up. So this is the paper that was laid down in my pan, and I placed different kinds of leaves. And you know, this big fern didn't give me too much, a little bit disappointed. I wish I had a wider view, because then I could, you see, this is the paper that were laid on top, so you can sort of do this. This is this, because it's the mirrored image. This is this, and the fern. So they give different prints, front and back, but I really love this, and you will see more of those leaves. Those are what I called red berries, but they're raspberries, and it gives the fine details in the leaves. So I'm not sure if this made a big difference from my earlier experiments without alum. So these are the sort of wild forget-me-nots, and did not give very much. There are some blue-gray things here, but this is not too interesting. Here it didn't give me anything at all. I think all the prints and colors you see are from the pages behind and above. These, you can see some tiny threads. These are the sort of moss plants, and I didn't have high hopes for them, but well, we have to experiment and see, right? Now this is really, really pretty. Yellow, bright, different leaves, and these were some of that grow wild in my garden. And look at this top page, how wonderful. Look at the difference on these leaves. So these are more like you have colored them in, if you see the stamens and all the details in two different ways. I love that. So this, I'm happy with this. but I have gotten great prints with leaves without alum too, but this time it was the colors of the flowers that I were very interested in learning about. And here you can see the poppies, I believe, that orange. It didn't give me much at all. Here are the mirrored image. You know, when I pressed those poppies with a hot iron, it gave me a neon orange color. So that was much nicer than this, but now we know that. Here we have the pansies, and they gave great colors, but not the best prints. This maybe you could tell are pansies, but the reason I can tell is because I know, and it's not so easy, and this is the mirrored image, but pretty colors. And here again we have different leaves, and I had a couple of those yellow flowers that I'm not sure what are called, but I love the leaves. And here again the mirrored image, same as earlier, you get different prints from top and bottom. So this is a greater print than, let's do this, and this, it's the same leaf. And these. So it, I guess it's a personal preference what kind of things you like the best. These are also the weeds that were almost lilac colored. They gave me blue, and I like this print. And these, of course, look at these. Ah, oh, these are gorgeous. The blue, and I think the middle one was the light pink, so that didn't give much color, but this was a blue one too, and look at the difference. Strange. So here are the mirrored image, and this is more detailed, this left. And I love these. Here we have, I think, are these the buttercups? It looks like it. No. I think these were some kind of wild flowers too. Can't exactly remember. And some leaves. And this is the opposite print. Here we have more of that raspberry leaves that I love so much. Look at this, and here, look at that branch. Oh, I absolutely love that. And this one too. Almost a brown purple color here. Really stunning. And this is the mirror. So again, this has more the contrasts, and this has the details. So, but here on this side you can see it changed. So I guess it depends on which way you layer down your leaf. And here are the buttercups. I'm pretty sure these are the buttercups. And they didn't give me yellow flowers. They are a little bit brownish, but you know, we added rusted things. And I forgot this time to add a little bit of vinegar. I usually add a little splash of vinegar in my water. I totally forgot, but I don't think it made a huge difference from my earlier experiments, but look at this, the iris, oh my gosh. And I'm trying now, let's see, let's turn this. This is, I'm looking in my camera and the colors looks very real. They are bright turquoise and I was so amazed when I saw the result of that iris. Isn't that great? It's amazing. I was totally blown away and excited. And these are rose leaves. So that color, oh my gosh. Now I wish I had a garden full of iris so I could do much more of them. And these were leaves. Oh, I think it's the foxgloves and the leaves from the foxgloves, maybe. Let's see. Here are, I'm not sure, but I can see this here looks like foxgloves. I do think it is that the foxglove page. And these are the very orange flowers that I had from my bush that gave me the amazing purple color on my eco print, and it didn't give me that amazing color here, but it still gave sort of a bluish purplish color, and you can see the details in some of them, and I'm happy with this print as well. This is just a huge mess. See here, those are the dried, all the dead dried flowers that I just placed all over the page, and you can see it gives colors for sure. Here you can see details of a couple of leaves from my yellow flower, but look, it has orange and yellow, so it's amazing how this works. And here we have these are also the foxglove. This page is the pretty page, so you can see it gives blue and shades and yellow too, but and this was a clover, I think. And this is just the top page. So you see, if you want to try to get the real impression of one particular flower of leaves, you need to put something in between your pages, because it's of course transparent through your next page. So maybe I will do that sometime, try to only try one sort of flower or leaves at the time, or place something behind the pages so I will see more in detail what gives what. And I'm very happy with this. I want to ask you that have tried using alum, because I feel that the paper has some sort of a layer of some powderish, I can't explain, but it seems like the alum is giving the paper a different texture. Not sure I like that too much, but maybe I could use a cloth or something and try to, I don't know. Let me know, those of you that have used alum, if you can feel the difference in the papers. And now the fabric, little bit disappointed. You can see here are a couple of big leaves. There are just some splotches of colors here and there. So not too exciting, really. Not any good prints, but I'm not sure this fabric, it came directly from the shop and I hadn't washed it, so I think that might make a difference because they are coated in some sort of things. So I think if I'm trying this again, I need to wash my fabric before I do it, and also maybe add some vinegar. But everything will be used one way or another, so you can use this for collaging, and it still has some pretty colors in it. So we will have to see during the summer when different plants are blooming, and I'm not sure how many of these eco-dyeing projects I'm going to do, because I've done a lot now, but I still find it fun, interesting, and I learn a lot, and it just takes a lot of time, and well, I'm not sure, but I hope you learned something from this, and let me know what you think. Let me know if you have tried iris, and if it gave you this color here. My guess is that it depends on where you are living, what the quality of the water, what the water contains, all that stuff, and the plants too, if you pick them early, late, and I think everything matters, even the quality of the rain, how much pollution is in the air, all those things. So probably we will all get different results, and that's so the whole fun about it. So let me know what you think. I hope you enjoyed, and I hope you're all doing well, and I hope I'll talk to you again soon. Bye bye.